Welcome to HDFC Securities 5-Minute Market Wrap-Up for the week ended June 28. Nifty rallied strongly this week to end higher by 2.2% lifted by Bank Nifty and other blue-chip leaders. Bank Nifty contributed to the rally with a gain of 1.3%. The mid and small cap indices underperformed this week, but closed in the green with gains of about 0.4%. Among sectoral gainers, Nifty Energy Index saw a gain of 3.3%. The telecom index rallied 3.2% after Jio announced a tariff hike. Among sectoral losers, Nifty Realty and Nifty Media saw a decline of 2.3% or more. In this week's Nifty 50, UltraTech Cement led with 9.4% surge, followed by Grasim at 8.3% while Reliance was up by 7.6%. In top 5 weekly Nifty 50 losers, the biggest fall in shares was witnessed by IndusInd Bank, down by 4.1%. Cipla, Eicher Motors, Tata Steel saw a fall of more than 3%. In select market movers, India Cements shares gained 26% after UltraTech Cement acquired a 24% stake in the company. Shares of Route Mobile surged 19% after the company signed an agreement with Microsoft and Proximus Group. Among losers, shares of Happiest Minds fell by 9.8% after the company's promoter sold a 6% stake in the company. Shares of CE Info Systems fell by 9% after the promoter sold stake in the company. FII activity was mixed this week and they ended the week with net purchases of about Rs 4,600 crores. DIIs had another strong month of net purchases. They net bought about Rs 28,600 crores of equities in cash during the month. This week saw 3 IPOs on the main board. Stanley Lifestyles Limited was subscribed 97 times. Ali Blenders IPO was subscribed about 25 times. Bridge Iron was a small IPO of Rs 171 crores and it was subscribed 126 times. Among listings, DEE Development Engineers listed with gains of 60%. Acme Fintrade listed with gains of 6%, while Stanley Lifestyles listed with gains of 34%. In the newsmakers section this week, Amara Raja Energy share price jumped 20% to hit an all-time high after the battery maker announced that it has entered into a technical licensing agreement with China-based Goshen Hi-Tech. Also on 25th June, ICICI Bank Ltd. became only the 6th Indian firm to hit a market capitalization of $100 billion. SEBI bars brokers and mutual funds from using unregulated financial influencers for marketing and advertising campaigns. In key macroeconomic news, Japan's CPI inflation increased by 2.1% in May, while Japan's retail sales rose by 3% in May, much higher than expectations of 2%. The US GDP grew by an annualized 1.4% in the first quarter of 2024 compared to earlier estimates of 1.3%. Moving to bond markets, India's 10-year bond yields climbed 4 basis points to end the week at 7.01%. The yields have been flat over the past 30 days. The US markets remained flat this week with the S&P 500 moving lower by 0.1%. The US 10-year bond yields inched up by 13 basis points to 4.39% after two Fed governors expressed doubts about the timing of rate cuts by the US Fed. In this section, we discuss select research reports published by our research teams. The same can be accessed on our website. For NECA, the BPC ambition of achieving mid-late 20s growth seems plausible, but its ambition to achieve 2.5 to 3x growth by FY27 seems a stretch. We retain a reduced rating with a target price of Rs 130 per share. The pizza category has a difficult history with challenges from price-sensitive nature and hyper-competition from regional and local players. We believe that Jubilant FoodWorks has made substantial efforts to tackle these challenges. We upgrade Jubilant to an ad from a reduce and increase the target price to Rs 685 per share. SB Apparels has an established position in the infant wear segment. The ban by US on all imports from Xinjiang region could benefit Indian companies. Management aims to grow its garmenting division at 7-10%. Our retail research team has assigned a base case fair value of 746 rupees per share. That is all for this week. Do refer to the detailed disclaimer on your screens. The securities discussed in the presentation were for information and educational purposes only. Thank you.